Hello everyone, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. Today we are going to discuss on the tutorial of debt ratio. The debt ratio, as you can see in this yellow box, debt ratio is one of the most used solvency ratio by the investors. So let's directly jump on the debt ratio formula. It is one of the most used solvency ratio by the investor and it's pretty easy to calculate too. Let's have a look at the formula of the debt ratio and get into the nitty-gritty. Now, the debt ratio formula is very simple actually. The debt ratio is equal to the total liabilities divided by the total asset. It is as simple as that. So basically we are comparing, as you can see, the total liability and assets. All you need to do is to look at the balance sheet and find out where a firm has enough total assets to pay off its total liability. If you go in the explanation part of the debt ratio formula, for investors, the financial statements are everything. They look at all four statements and make their judgments. One of the most important financial statements is balance sheet. By looking at the balance sheet, the investors are able to know what's working for a company and what's need to be improved. So two of the most important items on the balance sheets are assets and liabilities. By looking at the total assets and total liabilities, the investors are able to understand whether the firm has enough assets to pay off the liabilities. And that's exactly what we call as debt ratio. See, by using this ratio, we calculate the proportion of the total assets and total liabilities. And by looking at them, we get to know the stance of the company at any stage. Now, what is the use of the debt ratio formula? Let's look at that. This ratio is useful for two groups of people. The first group is the top management of the company, who is directly responsible for the expansion or contraction of a company. By using this ratio, the top management sees whether the company has enough resources to pay off its obligation. The second group is the investors who would like to see the position of the company before they ever put in their money into the company. And that's why the investors needs to know whether the firm has enough assets to bear the expense of the debt and other obligations. So this ratio also measures the financial leverage of the company. And it also tells us the investors how leveraged the firm is. If the firm has a higher level of liabilities compared to the assets, then the firm has more financial leverage and vice versa the case. Okay. So now let's look at the example of the debt ratio formula. Let's take a very practical example to illustrate this ratio. Boom Company has the following details that we are going to discuss here. The current asset, non-current asset details are, I'm just trying to pitch the details over here. The current liabilities, then we have the non-current liabilities. I'm just writing lab over here. So this are all the details, okay? And let's put the amount. This is the particulars and this are the amounts in dollars, okay? Now, the current assets is close enough to 30,000. Then we have the non-current assets as close enough to $3 lakh. Current liability, let's take as 40,000 and non-current liabilities as $70,000. Everything is in dollars. Now find out the debt ratio of Boom Company. This is, we are discussing for Boom Company. Okay. In the above example, we can see that we need to total the current and non-current assets and also the current liabilities and non-current liabilities. So the total assets are current assets plus non-current assets. So the current assets and the non-current assets is 30,000 plus 3 lakh. That is 3,30,000. Okay. So I'm just quickly going to write over here as is equal to 30,000 plus 3 lakh. That's the total of the total assets are current and non-current. Now the total liabilities are current liabilities and non-current liabilities. So let's make the total 40,000 plus 70,000, that's 1,10,000. Okay, so this are the two details. Okay, now the debt ratio formula is the total liabilities divided by the total asset. So what is the total liability over here? As you can see, 1,10,000. Okay, so our final answer is going to be is equal to the total liabilities divide by the total assets, that is 3,30,000. So our debt ratio comes to 0.3333. Okay. The ratio of the Boom Company is close enough to 0.33. So to know whether this proportion between the total liabilities and total asset is healthy or not, we need to see the similar companies under the same industry. If the ratio of those companies is also in the similar range, it means Boom Company is doing quite well. In the normal situation, as lower as this ratio can be better, as in terms of the investment and solvency. The debt ratio in terms of Excel with template, you know, we can take a look at that. And this is very simple. I mean, you need to provide the two inputs of total liabilities and total asset, and you can easily calculate the ratio in the template. As you can see in this particular template, whatever we have calculated in our Excel sheet is over here. You can see the current assets, non-current, the total assets 3,30,000. Okay, the current liabilities, non-current liabilities 40 + 70, 1,10,000. So the total asset, total liabilities and total asset, which gives us the debt ratio for the boom company. Now, basically you can use this debt ratio calculator to calculate your debt ratio. Okay, so let's put our total liability as 2,00,000 and our total asset as 1,00,000. So that gives us our debt ratio formula is 2x. So the debt is 2x the total assets. If we change the data to 1 over here and 2 over here, we'll get the debt ratio formula is 0.5x. It is usually considered 2 as a greater, it's a good number, it's a good way to calculate. Okay. And if we put things over here as 5 and 2 or 5 and 1 over here, you can see the debt ratio has increased to 5. See, 5x is a very leveraged company. Like, you know, companies like Jet Airways, it is capital intensive company. They have a debt close enough to 12,000 crores. That is in terms of INR, the Indian currency INR. Well, if you see, that is a highly leveraged company, and that the debt is close enough to 12,000. That means its debt ratio is close enough to 4.5x, which is really high. So such companies are really risking their cash flows, their operations, because majority of their profits or funds are blocked in interest. So the company should not be highly leveraged, or even if they are, then they should set off with some of the fixed deposits if they have any, so that, you know, you can set off the interest of the fixed deposit and the interest of the interest of the debt that you are going to pay. So this is a debt calculator. You can calculate the debt ratio with the help of this calculator. I hope you have got the concept regarding the debt ratio. Thank you.